next, I think, which is Matthew Perry's autobiography. I actually didn't know this was happening. I did not know that he was releasing an autobiography, and then I saw it in Waterstone. Enjoying the nail glue. Nuh-uh. I was gonna put on some fakes, but I don't know, they're finally getting a bit stronger. I hope you're okay with finger dabbing. And I'm gonna use a pen to do some tracing. Oh, a pen. I'll be right back. We're back. That's quite the dark paragraph. Okay, everything I'm reading is really dark. Okay, I found a not dark paragraph. Every evening I would head to the Formosa Cafe on Santa Monica Boulevard in West Hollywood with my friends. There were two signs over the bar. The one under all the headshots read, "Stars dine." strong mental state and remind yourself that these things are slow, and that's okay, and you just gotta keep going. And I have 40 wonderful subscribers. I love you all. So thank you so much, and that helps a million. But sometimes you just need a little help to take immediate control of your mental, emotional, physical, and financial destiny. So this is Tony Robbins. My partner loves him. Loves him. Loves him. I know nothing about him, but I trust my partner knows. Okay, shall I read you the blurb? Because we're both learning. I don't know either. Swept away by things that are seemingly out of your control. In Awaken, the Giant Within, Anthony Robbins, the best-selling author of Unlimited Power, shows the reader how to take immediate control of their mental, emotional, physical, and financial destiny. So I shall have to report back on all these. I don't know if you could understand what I was saying, but that was a slightly darker paragraph as well. To think about myself and think, what am I feeling, and delve inside myself to think about things. I just don't want to think anymore. So, moving on to my next hardback autobiography. Guys, I know I've only done a few videos, maybe even two Harry Potter videos. Favorite stood 30 of us in a line. One of the adults, I would later find out that this was the director, Chris Columbus, went down the line asking each of us which part of the book we were most excited to see on screen. I remember being underwhelmed by the question, as the responses came clear and certain. Hagrid Fang Quidditch. I remember standing there wondering if I could go home soon. It was only when it came to the turn of the kid next to me that I realised not only had I given the question zero thought, I had absolutely no idea what anybody was talking about. Who was Hagrid? What was a Quidditch? My neighbour announced that he was most excited to see Gringotts, and I thought to myself, what the hell are they? Some kind of flying animal, maybe? because this is fiction, I don't want to ruin any of it for myself. So I think I'll go in at the very beginning. Okay, ready? Sleeping in the car is cramped. The time doesn't know where to begin. There was a man who wrote a bunch of my body with those in when they bought the money. His death is the latent kind of cut, which is true. The latent to make the car bigger. Shall be filled with that, which is sleep in the back. I don't think that is large. He has to be in the front door. He did the dress shop with ability to function under the circumstances. He says she'll be too busy dreaming to drive, so shall make it in the space. But even though he has to cut up accidentally up because she can't affect the stranger. Oh, I'm looking forward to reading a fiction. I'm trying to think what my last fiction book I read was. No. But it must have been at least 4 books ago. Not sure. This one isn't, like, new. Let me see the date it was published, the year it was published. 2019. Yeah, so it's a few years old now, but I never got round to reading it. So it's by Elton John. It's Elton John's autobiography. It's very minimalist on the back. It just says, the great thing about rock and roll is that someone like me star. Oh, I like that. It's true. Readjust. Oh, sorry, everyone. He's just called it me. That's it. Me. Me. It's all about me. By Elton John. Except in the E we've got this star. Okay. Let's make a page. Less if I pick a random page. Shall I just no, actually let's read you the blurb. It's in the inside cover. Okay. Elton is the most enduringly successful singer-songwriter of all time. His life is extraordinary. His 7 decades so far, packed with incredible highs and lows, now in his own words, and with his usual honesty to share his story. The truth about his childhood growing up in the London suburb of Pinner and his difficult relationships with his parent. Christened Reginald Dwight, he was a shy boy with unlikely dreams of pop stardom. By the age of 23, he was performing his first gig.